Now, taking a deep breath, Patsy stood up. If she really wanted Tim for her own, she would have to be honest with him. But how would he feel if he knew that she'd interfered in his friendship with Rosie? Surely he would understand that Patsy had only acted out of her love for him. Perhaps he would not mind that she'd meddled with his personal affairs. Smoothing down her starched white apron, she headed for the door of the hut. There was only one way to find out how Tim would react, and that was to confront him, spill the beans, and see what came of it. As she opened the cookhouse door, she saw Tim walking towards the parade ground. She was about to call out to Sheila that she would be a few minutes late, but then she changed her mind. Maybe if she just gave their relationship a little longer, she could learn to live with her deception. Besides, what good would telling him do anyway? Not only could she lose Tim, but he might even end up turning to Rosie for comfort. Sheila was scowling at her. Are you coming in or not? The spud's what need peeling, and I ain't doing them on me own. When this war's over, I swear I'll never peel another spud again as long as I live. Her mind made up, Patsy let Tim continue on his way. Pass me a knife, she said, and settled next to her friend. Chapter 11. Spring 1944. Maggie was sitting at the big kitchen table eating a bowl of porridge laced with honey. It was her turn on early milking, something she quite enjoyed, and so far only herself and the other land girl, Penny Roberts, were awake on Plevin's farm. I'll stick us a couple of slices of toast on. It's right sharp out there this morning, and I want a full belly before I venture into the milking shed, Penny said, as she scraped the last bit of porridge from her bowl. I'm going to have some damson jam on mine. Do you want the same? Maggie shrugged. I'm easy. I'll have whatever we've got the most of. She took a large gulp of her tea and turned her attention back to the letter she'd received from Ken the day before. My darling Maggie, I was so glad to get your last letter. It sounds as if farming life is really suiting you.